ABC7 presents Eyewitness Newsmakers with Adrienne Alpert.
Today on Eyewitness Newsmakers, the growing homeless crisis, more than 20,000 on the city's streets. Our guest, L.A. City Councilman Mike Bonin, who's asking for safe havens, not sidewalks. He's looking for more options to get the homeless off the streets, transitional shelters, emergency shelters. We'll ask how he plans to make it happen.
We are back with Los Angeles City Councilman Mike Bonin from the 11th District. Good morning to you.
Good morning. Glad to be here. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for joining us. We're going to begin with an op-ed piece that you've recently written calling for safe havens, not sidewalks for the homeless. Mm-hmm. What do you specifically propose that's different and new that will change this situation?
What I propose is that instead of having a sort of a binary system where you either have the sort of golden lottery ticket for permanent supportive housing, or the sidewalk, that we have a menu or a continuum of service options and solutions in between the sidewalk and permanent supportive housing. We have a system now where we don't have enough supply to meet our demand. And what we do then is say, okay, sleep on the sidewalks.
Well,
and
by court order, the city must allow the homeless to sleep on the sidewalks.
Well, about 10 years ago, the Ninth Circuit Court ruled that it was cruel and unusual punishment for the city to tell people they can't sleep on sidewalks if you don't provide enough housing or shelter. And I think the city fathers at that time took sort of the easy route and said, okay, sleep on the sidewalks. And 10 years later, we're seeing that we've become a city of tent cities, of encampments, of shanties. And all over the city, from the valley to San Pedro, my district to the east side and downtown, we have literally tens of thousands of people camping on the streets, in our parks, in front of kids' schools. It's not good for neighborhoods, clearly, but it's also not good for homeless people. In this year's homeless census count, we saw homelessness had gone up 12%. We also saw within that homeless people who are mentally ill and chronic homelessness also went up. If we're normalizing living on the streets and you're mentally ill and you're living on the streets, you're probably going to get sicker. And if we're normalizing living on the streets where it's harder to access services, you're going to go from episodically to chronically homeless.
And yet we go to ribbon cuttings where there's a few hundred new supportive housing mm-hmm. units, but we're talking tens of thousands.
Yes.
And what do you propose that in between, where could they go, what could they be?
What we need to have is a series of different options, as I said, between the streets and permanent supportive housing. And that's got to include different types of shelters, emergency shelters, transitional shelters. It's got to include sort of smaller safe havens like they're doing in New York, sobering centers where people can go and sober up instead of going to an emergency room and driving up costs. Also shared housing, which has been a successful model in my part of town, where people who are homeless will work with an agency and several of them will wind up living together. Less costly than permanent supportive housing. The trick, though, there's two tricks, really, is we can't do big warehouse shelters. They can't be like prisons where people don't want to go.
So cots in big rooms, empty warehouses.
Yeah, New York has done that, and it hasn't really worked. One, it becomes, instead of a way station towards the next step in solving your solution and getting you to housing, it turns out to be warehousing, and you get stuck there.
And so what do you propose, and when do you propose it? Is something coming up this coming week?
Our homeless committee, which is a new committee, is meeting this week, and we'll begin to continue the discussions on this this week and in the next few months. What I'd like us to do is sort of price out how much it would cost to come up with this menu. Part of what we need to do is specialize more. We have a lot of folks, people say, oh, they're service resistant, they'll never go to a shelter. I make a distinction between service resistant and service reluctant. I met a couple in Venice who have lost everything in the world. Everything, their home, their car, and they won't go to a shelter. And it's because the one thing they've left in life is each other. And at a shelter, they would get separated by gender. And for them, that violates their survival instinct. So why can't we do shelters where couples can go? Or people who have pets can take their pets?
Ultimately, in our final couple seconds on this topic, could there be some way, if you got enough of these beds, that then you could close down Skid Row and just say no one gets to sleep there anymore? Is that your ultimate goal here?
Ultimately, I think the city would be given the option legally of saying you can't sleep on the sidewalk if we've provided an alternative option for everybody else. And I'd like us to do that. And I think we need many smaller options for folks instead of the big warehouses. I'd like us to give permission to churches or synagogues to open up their facilities or parking lots. New York has begun to do that. Also, at the same time, we need safe parking places for people who are living in their vehicles or RVs. We don't want to tell them, get out of your car, you can sleep on the sidewalk. We want to put them someplace safe.
Well, all right, Councilman, we have to take a quick break.
Sure.
We'll be back with some more topics right after this.
Thanks.